Dear friends, dear colleagues, my name is Alexander Batthyány. I'm in Vienna. I think some of you know me and I know some of you. I have the honor and pleasure to know some of you. I'm here in Vienna at the Viktor Frankl Institute and I would like to first of all greet all of you, second of all greet all of you and welcome you to this conference. And I would also, and especially and wholeheartedly from our whole team here, would like to congratulate you for the 20th birthday of the initiative in Valencia. Very active, I know how active you are because I've been visiting a few years ago and saw a wonderful group of highly dedicated people working towards and for logotherapy. And I also know, because we are planning, as you know, perhaps know, that the next World Congress of Logotherapy is going to take place in Valencia. We have to see when, but it's going to take place in Valencia. So this comes with very warm greetings. I'm looking forward to meeting you for a dialogue and to continue working in this beautiful field. Speaking of dialogue, I was also asked, and I do so hesitantly, to tell you, I think, but perhaps it's good news, that Herder Editorial, the publisher, recently, a few days, actually yesterday, published a new book, a translation of a work, of a dialogue between Elisabeth Lucas, who happens to be my teacher in logotherapy, and myself. And we tried to, actually, it's not a ready set book. It's a dialogue, and we try to bring out and to bring into logotherapy or a logotherapeutic perspective on a whole range of topics, which so far have not fully been addressed in logotherapy because they are very up to date, they're very contemporary, such as the pathology of the zeitgeist, how does it and how did it change with the advent of the internet and of Twitter and email and so on. And at the same time, we also talk about mindfulness meditation and how it relates to logotherapy. And Elisabeth Lucas brought up or developed a logotherapeutic mindfulness meditation. It's a very own special device. We talk about contemporary research on logotherapy and how different schools connect to us and we connect to them. About former colleagues such as Alfred Lengle and how his work differs, I think strongly differs from our work and the question whether it is compatible or not. So we talk about the near-death experience, we talk almost anything under the horizon, under the sky, we discuss, and I hope this is going to be useful to some of you, perhaps even to many of you. And I think, next to praising this book, which I now have done, this is the advertisement, there's an even more important aspect to it. And that is that we need and we can bring logotherapy into the 21st century. It is, if you look at it, and this is something I discovered while writing or while doing this book, is how enormously contemporary, modern, how future-oriented logotherapy is. So it's not an old school, it's an ever-fresh idea which needs to be expanded, which needs to be tested against the zeitgeist. And I hope that the spirit of dialogue is going to be a new spirit in logotherapy. And what could be better than a congress for this? So with this, I release you. I wish you a wonderful time together, many good and spirited discussions, and hope to see all of you very, very, very soon. All the best from Vienna. Bye-bye.